All right, hello everyone. I'm rolling solo on the Lou Later set. We have some news that took place today. A surprise, a sneaky little announcement from Apple. They're not chilling. They're not resting. They're still putting stuff out. Granted, in a bit of a different way. They didn't have an event. There was no big fanfare, of course, because of the current state of planet Earth. They did it virtually. They did it from a distance. They did a no guest announcement. And some people are talking about it, so I figured I would check it out for myself and we could look at it together. It is a new iPad Pro. Let's go ahead and roll this clip real quick. We'll keep the music off, but you see a similar design to the previous version, but some new accessories. The most advanced mobile display. Some improvements. It's going to be a faster unit. A12Z Bionic. They keep trying to tell you, they keep trying to convince people, this is the future of computing. It's not your laptop. They went ahead and put the new camera system in there as well, adding the ultra-wide. They put a LiDAR scanner in there. They want this to be your AR machine so that you can, look around your room and imagine what furniture from IKEA looks like. Interior designers and so on will probably like that. For me, the most exciting is the new keyboard. I got to pause this real quick. The new keyboard. All right. The magic keyboard / trackpad. They added real legit trackpad support for the iPad. And they put a keyboard on there that I might actually use. And if you recall, I've done challenges in the past attempting to use the iPad Folio keyboard and replace my laptop with an iPad permanently. But the keyboard eventually just, it would kill me. At some point, I'd say, I want some tactile feedback, and this really cool stand which makes it look like the iPad itself is floating, magnetically attached. Now, granted, I don't know. I immediately, when I saw that, I thought about, what about on the lap? It looks really nice, and I believe it even charges your iPad from the keyboard case. So it's a product more like what Microsoft is doing with their Surface products. And actually, at this point, I feel like Microsoft has maybe blurred the line more than Apple as far as what constitutes a laptop and what constitutes a tablet. And this is a little bit of catch-up work from Apple with this particular case to blur that line even further, although they think they blurred it a long time ago with these titles. Your next computer is not a computer. This is not a computer. This is a computer. This is the only computer, and so forth, constantly saying the word computer. You add the Apple Pencil, you just have a versatile package and an exciting product. So that's the initial promo video, but then they put out another video called How to Correctly Use a Computer. And this is a stylish video. Of course, Apple knows how to make a video, don't they? This one, it's got a little Wes Anderson vibe to it with the yellow font, the aged looking font. And you have some very Apple-looking people in here doing very Apple-ish things, wearing AirPods Pro, using iPad Pros, being messy because they can, because they have Apple products and they're allowed and they can throw the iPad around and play games on it. And again, it's along the similar line that this is the future of computing. You don't have to be tethered to a desk. Your computer itself is a thing that changes form frequently, that can flip around, and now you have this keyboard case, which does a better job of completing the laptop replacement, which is the thing that I've been talking about asking for. They also go into showing you that you could take it wherever you want. You can take photos with it. Your computer doesn't have a camera, although I never felt personally all that comfortable or confident taking a photo on an iPad. And then, of course, you can draw on it. They're still trying to sell you the Apple Pencil. All right, so let's break it down. What do we have here? There's a lady in a bathtub. She was just in a bathtub watching some videos real quick there. Your next computer is not a computer. All right, we get it. Thank you very much. Now we need to break down, well, what does this all mean? Should you care? You probably do. I mean, you're watching the video. You care to a certain degree. Plus, let's be honest, you're trapped indoors. We've covered that. You need something to watch here. So we're all watching what Apple is doing, including myself and now yourself. It's not just, by the way, it's not just a new iPad that they put out and these new accessories. They also put out a new MacBook Air. and they fixed the keyboard. So you probably noticed I'm looking at a MacBook right now. This is the new 16-inch model with the fixed keyboard, with going back to the scissor mechanism away from the butterfly mechanism. And what can I say? This keyboard's been fine. It's not my favorite keyboard in the world, but it's certainly an improvement over the butterfly thing, because I had two separate units personally, plus one of Will's units, failed because a crumb or whatever it is that happens. Those keyboards were just a little bit too sensitive, as you're probably aware at this point. So they add the new old keyboard, the scissor mechanism keyboard from the 16-inch laptop that I'm looking at right here, into the MacBook Air. And that's where things get weird. You put out a new MacBook Air, you put out this really cool iPad. They don't even make a video for the MacBook Air. They don't care about the MacBook Air. The MacBook Air is not a computer. Your next computer is not a computer. You understand? They'd rather sell you the iPad. And there's probably, I think there's some good reason for it from a business perspective. If they sell you the new iPad, plus you go ahead and get the new keyboard case for it, let me tell you what you're looking at from a price tag perspective. Here we're on MacRumors.com. They've covered everything quite well here in depth. You go for the 12.9-inch model. It starts at $1,000, but if you add a little bit more storage, I mean, let's be honest, you can get it up to $1,200. And then the 12.9-inch Magic Keyboard attachment is $350. So you could easily be at $1,500. You're in MacBook Pro territory. Now, I get it. You're flipping around. You're having a time. You're like the people in the commercial there. You're taking photos. You're in the back seat of the car. You're always on the go. That's a funny thing, isn't it? That commercial, there's no pandemic going on in that commercial. Those people are freewheeling. They're having fun. So obviously, we're going to have to wait. We're going to have to wait for a time in which society's back to its free-flowing nature to truly appreciate how to correctly use a computer. Because right now, I bet there's a lot of people sitting on couches and at desks, and you're not in the back of a car, and you're not laying down in a public space like they're doing in that particular commercial. But anyways, so what I'm trying to get at here, the new MacBook Air, traditional Intel processor, full-fledged desktop operating system and all the software that comes with that, starting at $1,000, and if you add the Magic Keyboard to the 12.9-inch new iPad Pro, even the baseline model with 128 storage and only Wi-Fi, and you're already up to $1,349, a substantial increase. So I realize they're different products. I realize there's nothing really futuristic about the new MacBook Air other than just fixing the things that are wrong with it. But it really feels like increasingly Apple doesn't want you to buy the MacBook Air. They would much prefer if you purchased this iPad ecosystem. Also, the software on the iPad appears to be of great importance to them. They're investing a lot in developing that software, and they want more people to experience it. So I kind of understand it. Another cool thing that happened here, the new accessories are going to be compatible with the previous, with the old version iPad. So if you bought the iPad Pro from, I guess, last year, the 11 or 12.9-inch, then you can buy this new cool attachment. Granted, you can already order the new iPad Pro, but you cannot get the new Magic Keyboard until May. It'll be available in May in the 11-inch and the 12.9-inch version. Also, the 12.9-inch version attachment is going to be $50 more than the 11-inch version. That's kind of interesting. I'm curious, the whole weight thing, it starts getting heavy when you put it all together, but I get it. It's a transformer. You don't need to carry all the components at all times. But I've kind of had this experience myself where by the time I had the iPad Pro all stocked up with the smart folio and all the rest of it, I'm sitting there saying, man, I have laptops that are lighter than that, and I use it most of the time in a laptop form factor. Me, personally. I just got to be honest with it. Okay, so just rounding out the new specifics here, A12Z Bionic chip, the new Magic Keyboard accessory with the built-in trackpad and trackpad support within the software dating back to the old version, ultra-wide camera, the LiDAR scanner for that better AR performance, and they say that it's faster and more powerful than most Windows PC laptops. Well, you know they had to take a shot, didn't they? But then again, there's a lot of old Windows PC laptops out there. And what is faster? What is more powerful? Does it sound, if I can't get the software I'm looking for, what does it matter? Maybe within certain software that holds true. Nonetheless, you're trying to sell the thing. Of course, you're going to say it. All right. So for me, the thing that I'm most excited about checking out is going to be that new keyboard case. I want to tap those key switches as you would, as I do, as I'm interested in. And you're obviously well aware of that. And I just want to see the floating mechanism and how it does on the lap. I think it's curious that in their video, it wasn't on the lap. It was mostly just sitting on surfaces. It looks cool that way, but I wonder about the weight distribution. It's got a real impact visually. You go ahead and you order it. For example, with the Microsoft product, the Surface Book, the one with the detachable tablet portion, it ends up top heavy. And then you try to put it on a lap and it wants to fall back. Now, that one's not terrible because it is a traditional laptop form factor when it's connected. But this one, to me, it has a top heavy appearance to it. So I'm a bit curious. You throw it on a lap. Does it want to tip over? Hopefully not. Hopefully they were able to engineer around that. That would be pretty amazing if they were. So I want to get my hands on that, but it's not until May. Anyways, and we have bigger fish to fry in the meantime, as you're well aware. But nonetheless, it's cool to see some things still happening in tech, some sense of normalcy, Apple still announcing things and putting things out, even if it's in this diminished format here, just squeaking out a couple videos on YouTube. It still gives us something to watch and to feel like the world is still moving. Because it is, Apple's got a lot of money on the line, a lot of products in the pipeline. I promise you, for them, things are very, very much still moving. Your next computer is not a computer video. 3.7 million views in 7 hours. People seem to care. They're interested. I'm at least glad they're attempting to push the form factor forward. As much as I'm a laptop guy, I'm always looking at a laptop. It's, you do wonder what that next computing, productive computing platform is. Is it just the smartphone? Is it a bigger smartphone? Is it what Apple's doing with the iPad Pro? I still like keyboards. You know this. So I'm glad they're paying some degree of attention to that. So anyway, there you go. That's a solo mode from the Lou Later set. Little update. Hopefully you guys appreciated it, enjoyed it. I don't know. What do I know? It's 2020. Things are crazy. I know very little. What I do know is I'm still trying to keep it moving just like Apple is. So I'll be here. I'll talk to you maybe tomorrow.